Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you'd like to subscribe to my channel, click the red button. If you'd like to be notified of my posts first, click the bell. And also feel free to give my video a thumbs up and also share it if you liked it. So I'm following the devastating volcano in Hawaii. There are 17 more fissures that have opened up. The 17th one was several hundred yards in length. These fissures are basically openings into the earth that are, you know, can start spurting out gases and lava, and it's more reason for people to evacuate and get out of harm's way. The 18th fissure opened up this morning, and they have this volcano has successfully destroyed 37 structures so far. 2,000 plus people have been evacuated, and it doesn't look like this is going to subside. It looks like it's getting worse. It doesn't seem to be calming down. The area has, you know, just been devastated. There's been gallons and gallons, 60,000 of gallons cleared that were flammable out of the way of this, of the lava that's coming straight for it, kind of thing. The eruption, you know, the ashes have spread for like 12 miles. People are definitely feeling the effects of this huge volcano. So, you know, if you folks are able to help in any way, shape, or form, please reach out to the Hawaii officials and let them know that you're able to help. There are reportedly spatter bombs of up to 500 feet in the air that are being seen from like reports from the U.S. Geological Survey and stuff. They are very, very much stressing that anybody in that area, please do evacuate to safety, because the longer that you stay, you risk the authorities' lives as well as your own for them having to come in and rescue you when they have, you know, specifically laid out where this is headed and who it's affecting and who needs to evacuate. I know that it's really hard to lose everything, but you know, there's that old saying, you come into the world with nothing and you're going to leave with nothing. So really, this is just temporary anyways. Take the memories that are important to you, that are carryable, and get yourself to safety, because there's nothing worth losing your entire life over. So you can rebuild. You know, and speaking of the rebuilding, I was doing a little bit of research because I wanted to know, how do people rebuild on lava rock after it's cooled, and how do they, you know, get that to be flat land and grassy and earth again? And, you know, okay, so it was in Costa Rica, and 20 years ago there was a pasture that was just choked and it didn't have any life left to it. They weren't really sure what to do with it, but there was some students or professors at the University of Pennsylvania that had an idea to dump 12,000 tons of orange peels, because there was a new orange juice company that had opened up in Costa Rica, and so they needed a place to sort of put their extra pulp and peels and things like that. And so it was, there was this study that was sort of created to see what would happen if they sort of dumped all of these peels and pulp into this barren land. And what ended up happening was the entire land was overflown with fresh new life, and you know, it's just it's in an abundance. I mean, it's unbelievable. I will show a picture to you folks of how that ended up turning out. But 12 metric tons of the orange peel waste dumped into this land, it created a forest. I mean, trees and plants and greenery that, you know, you just don't see anymore. And all of that from just some leftover peels and pulps. So I find that to be encouraging. I think that maybe this can be something that Hawaii would try to sort of rebuild their lands that have been overtaken by some of the lava. If this is something that worked there, it may work here in or there in Hawaii. So I think it's worth a mention at the very least. So quite an interesting story for sure. It just goes to show you that not necessarily everything that's garbage is necessarily waste, and if it can be reutilized in a way to create something amazing on Earth, then let's try it and let's see what we can make, right? I think it's really interesting that the orange treatments that injected like the essential nutrients like potassium and nitrogen and the phosphorus that you find in soils, that was what was able to be recreated by dumping that there, and then the rest just was overtaken by Mother Nature and and it just grew in abundance, like absolutely amazing. At the very least, I would think that that is encouraging to know that we can rebuild on land that has been destroyed by, volcano. So take up your things that are your good memories and then rebuild them and recreate them, in the future and maybe not so close to the volcano, in my opinion, right? Stay safe, folks. This is devastating time for people who are losing everything. So let's try to be there for each other and stay safe. So thanks for watching. Bye for now, and please like, comment, subscribe, share my videos. I'd love to hear if you are affected by this Hawaii volcano, or if you have been in a volcano in the past, like in the zone where you've had to evacuate. Maybe you've traveled somewhere and something happened. I would love to hear about any stories that you folks have. So please share in the comments below. Bye for now, folks.